Friends, welcome back to my channel. In last video, we discussed buck converter. Buck converter receives voltage and it slices this voltage into specified duty cycle and it steps down the voltage to our load. For example, here we are providing 12 volt and we need 5 volt, 4 volt, whatsoever. This converter, this regulator will provide step down voltage from this supply. Here inductor is connected after the MOSFET, after the switch, and we have diode here, then a capacitor, load resistance. In the turn on time, the current flows from this switch, inductor, load and return path. When this switch is off, the stored energy in this coil, in this inductor, will collapse, magnetic field will collapse, and it will provide reverse polarity voltage to the applied voltage. So this end will become negative, this end will become positive, so it provides secondary current in the off time. So the load will receive regulated voltage. Today we are discussing boost converter. Boost converter is approximately similar to the buck regulator, but its circuit has some different configuration. We apply voltage to the inductor. Here we applied voltage to the switch, but here to the inductor, positive voltage, and then we connect the switch here, transistor, MOSFET, IGBT, whatsoever, and we connect this to return line. We can say this is our switch, and we have one diode connected in series with this coil. When the switch is off, positive voltage will pass through the inductor to the diode to the capacitor and to the load. When we have 0% duty cycle, at that time we will receive, I am providing 12 volt minus diode drop voltage, forward voltage for this diode, 11.72 volt we are receiving in the output at across the load, across this capacitor. But when we will turn on this switch, we will provide a signal here. What will happen? It will make a surge here. This is negative line and this is positive line, so this switch will close. It will cause to create heavy magnetic field in this coil, in this inductor, so it will store energy. When it will turn off, normally this end was positive, this end was negative. Why? Because due to load, this is high side, this is low side. When we apply surge, magnetic field expands. Then in the off time it will collapse. When it will collapse, coil, this end will become negative, this end will become positive. So we have two sources here. If we have one source here, positive, negative, positive, negative. So this positive, coil, this end is now negative, this end is positive. This voltage plus the created EMF by this inductor will add it together. Why? Because if we see here, we have one battery here, negative, positive, and the second battery, negative end is here. This will behave as a battery, negative, positive. So we will receive two added series batteries and we will receive voltage here, V out. Let's check now. Here we have 0%. Now I will add 1%, 11.72 volt. Now I will increase the duty cycle from here. It is switching at 65 kilohertz. I am not using a special inductor. I am using just only a transformer, a simple transformer, SMPS transformer. It is just for experiment. It have its very critical calculation to design this inductor. The voltage are now increasing. 12.26, 12.40. Now the voltage are being added. How much time we will allocate to turn on this MOSFET from here, this switch, it will create the magnetic field. And the inductor size will define the output voltage, how much volt we want to add. 13 volt, 15 volt, 56% we applied 12 volt, but we are receiving approximately 16-17 volt. It depends on how much magnetic field we are storing here in this inductor. If we have a working feedback system that will sense voltage from this point, and we apply this feedback loop here to this PWM controller, so it will control the duty cycle to adjust the voltage here. Then this boost converter, it needs current sensor. How much current we are drawing from this switch, because it will provide a direct surge on DC rail. If this transistor or this system is bad or anything is wrong, this system must turn off automatically. So we have different things to be considered for this boost converter. It monitors DC rail, DC current, and output voltage. We monitor DC rail. If the DC rail will drop too much at that time, this system must remain off, otherwise it will make heavy surge, so it cannot create strong magnetic field. If the DC current is too high, that can damage everything. So in short circuit condition, this system must remain off. If the voltage are under limit or above limit, this system must remain off. So these are the protection while designing these boost converters. And this boost converter, it is nowadays, it is used in every system. If we say air conditioner, outdoor unit boards, power supplies, computer power supplies, it is called PFC circuit, power factor correction circuit. So it is very useful circuit and most commonly used in the systems. So to maintain the voltage, it controls its turn on time. If the voltage are increasing in the output, it will decrease its duty cycle. If the voltage are decreasing, it will increase the duty cycle to maintain the voltage in the output line. It is also used in small circuits. We need 12 volt from 5 volt source. Just a small boost converter module is connected. It is similar to buck converter. So that module maintains the voltage in the output. So this is the working principle of this boost converter. I hope this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.